Hi everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are going to see how to play Bus Simulator Ultimate on PC. As you can see, you are displaying it on screen. It will be possible to simply download and install Bus Simulator Ultimate and play your game on a Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So without further ado, let's go. Before anything else folks, to start we need to open our favorite web browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to that URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type it, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. Once clicking on the link, we get to the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Bus Simulator Ultimate on our PC. It is now obvious that we access some pros of preferring using the emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we will start downloading the Bus Simulator Ultimate by simply clicking on the button Download Bus Simulator Ultimate on PC that you can visualize here in green. We then click on that button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's a file to execute. What we have to do is to run the executable file. Okay, so we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the system. We said yes. I minimize the browser to start to see the installation software better. The installation software is quite simple. It is made up of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I am going to explain what setup path does. We purely simply click on it. And so we see that we display here the path where in fact the emulator will be put in. If we want to change this folder, we have got to click on the browse option, and now we pick another folder and install the emulator where we desire. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. I click on back, therefore I click on install. At this time, before starting setting up this emulator, it's possible that it'll show us one or more application packages to install on the laptop. Because I do not want to have any of these software, I merely press many times on the reject option. Fantastic! The installation commences and it is going to continue together with the download of these megabytes which are visible on the computer screen. After you save it on your computer, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed can be faster or at a lower speed, depending on your type of connection and according to the performance of the emulator servers. Now they are running rather fast. The download is finished, and instantly it continues on with the installation step. The installation will take a little bit more or less time, primarily based on the power of your laptop or computer. The more robust it actually is, the faster the installation time and vice versa. If we join the download and software setup step, it normally takes quite a long time, so show patience. It is by now finished for me. At present, the emulator has been started on autopilot. As you can discover, down here, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right when it reaches the end, the emulator can be started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. And consequently LD Store is automatically started, which is actually a kind of Google Play. This is simply not the most correct way to set up the video game, and therefore I will not suggest it, given that oftentimes the LD Store installs an outdated version of the video game. I am about to tell you the right way to install the Android game though using Google Play, and therefore I recommend you to do it this way. The initial thing we must begin doing is to head to the desktop by simply clicking this icon that I am indicating in green color. Before we keep going, as you can see, it created a couple of icons right here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon will be only one we are concerned with. Every time we desire to start Bus Simulator Ultimate on our PC, we double mouse click on this particular app icon and run the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon is not related to multiplayer or anything at all like that. In reality, it's an software icon that we will most certainly never work with. Shall we do the next phase, which is actually a must, and that's to access the Google Play Store. To execute this we will go here to System Apps, we click on. And we'll click on Play Store. As you understand, the Google Play is launched. In this case we have got to sign in. Presently when we're right here, we are required to begin doing the next step that is imperative. So we just click on Sign In. Presently it says, checking info. It might occasionally get stuck in checking info, and so it does not move forward. In this case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a few hours, but it will surely probably be fixed. At this time we are going to type our email address and password. The email must be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example, you can utilize the exact same email address you're using at this time in your YouTube account. Thus I will provide my details and I will go back immediately after I have completed it. Voila, data typed. Find out Google welcoming us and providing us the terms of service. We are going to consent to them all by pressing, I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might leave it checked and it will create a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. By now Google Play is launched by default and instantly. In the event that the Google Play isn't launched automatically and you have no clue how to start it manually, I teach you how to do it right. First thing is to proceed to the emulator desktop by hitting this icon designated in green color. So now we go to the System Apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Great, we're right inside of Google Play. What we will accomplish now is go here to search for apps and games. And we're going to research Bus Simulator Ultimate. Currently there we end up with it, we can click on the first result. On this page we have the Android game. How about we click on there on the install button that I'm showing now in green color. This action will start the software setup. Right now it should download and install the game. It normally takes quite some time or it might well be extremely fast. That all is subject to on our internet connection. It's by then completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking on the following option that I am presenting in green, in order to launch Bus Simulator Ultimate for the first time. You are already on the emulator desktop, and then we're about to just click on this new Bus Simulator Ultimate app icon that was created. Your game is started for the first time. Currently there we get it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the sound level of that emulator. It is here, we have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we should turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. This one is the very first one, we simply click on this software icon that I am actually showing in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case that we want to launch the app in full screen, we select this icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen mode. To exit the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And thus we would just play in normal computer screen mode. At this point, I am going to clarify you the keys mapping which is really very appealing. That step we will certainly be in a position to utilize the game app far more easily. The first point is to press this app icon. And at this time there you will be able to complete the appropriate adjustments. I'm going to leave the default settings, though if you like to adjust that, you can easily do this without any problem. I use this opportunity to say that on occasion, when beginning the game app a black screen appears, if it is like that and you see the black display and this emulator fails to launch, I comment a feasible alternative. We can go here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator options, in the advanced selection we have got numerous resolutions. This is the resolution we have now chosen automatically, therefore we must select any of these additional image resolutions, for example that one here. We go for it and click on save. It is going to require us to restart the emulator and right after rebooted, most probably the emulator will get started and this black display will be completely removed. As you can observe, the emulator is completely in our own language. On occasion it happens that the emulator is launched in the wrong language, for instance, in Mandarin. And thus to set it in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. And thus here throughout various other configurations, we just click on the language drop down. We can decide on the language we wish, German, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is decided, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, along with the game application, the next time we use it, would of course be in the preferred language. Presently, there is another point that we need to take into account, and it's that we will receive an email reporting that a completely new device has been associated with our own Google account. It will certainly check with us if we are the ones who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we may not worry, simply because the emulator is behaving like an Android device. So you can see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Be sure you go here to the model selection. And there we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my video tutorial. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that you thought it was informative. If that's the case, allow it a great thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, concerns or ideas, let them in the comment area below. You could even leave comments on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every once in a while, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click any of the video tutorials which are usually showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the future video game videos. Bye.